And Vandy plays tough. We've been watching them on tape, and their players play smart, play tough, aggressive. And hopefully we can go to Nashville and play like a good team. Hopefully we can sort of play better as we continue going through the season. So we're looking forward to the challenge. It'll be a different environment. Obviously, having three at home here at Williams-Brice, having all the huge home crowd, which was instrumental in our success last week and the week before, won't quite be there at Vanderbilt. But I'm sure we'll have a good congregation of our fans in Nashville to help cheer us on. So we're looking forward to this game and see if our team can continue to improve as we go through the season. And we still got a lot of room for improvement. So hopefully that'll happen when we go to Nashville this week.
Coach, with just how big that Georgia game usually is every year, and then the win you just picked up like that, you know, how do you, what are you doing during practice? How do you keep not even your players, but even your coaches as well, of going into a Vanderbilt a game like this and not having, you know, I guess we'd say.
Well, first of all, we got a lot of room for improvement. If you've looked at all the stats where we rank in the conference and so forth, offense, defense, special teams, Vanderbilt, by the way, has scored. I think two special team scores already, two special team touchdowns. They got a defensive touchdown, so they're ahead of us in those categories. But anyway, we're trying to get better ourselves. I think we are. I hope we are. If we think we're a pretty good team just because we beat Georgia with a lot of good breaks, then we're fooling ourselves. We got a lot of room for improvement if we're going to have a chance to have a big year. So hopefully our guys know that. I think they do. Had a good practice last night. Expect to have a good one all this week. I mean, we realize how fortunate we were. We realize, you know, guy missed two field goals he never misses, and intentional grounding on a 4-yard line. I mean, it's just amazing how it happened, and we're thankful and appreciative, and hopefully we can take advantage of some real good breaks and not depend on that all the other games as we go through the season. We had to calm Dylan down. Well, he never did really calm down the other night. But our entire bench was jumping around too much after Brandon had that touchdown run, put us up by, 11 or 12, whatever it was. I said, man, there's 13 minutes left. You guys act like the game's over. It's way too big a celebration. And Dylan was part of it. I said, Dylan, man, you're the quarterback. You're not supposed to be jumping around like it's over. Just keep the guy's mind on the game. And fortunately, it worked out for us. Fortunately, there was only two more possessions each team in the 13 minutes. So that's the way it worked out.
Mm-hmm. Coach, you've talked about some of your players bringing that emotion and that passion on the sidelines, going on an environment like Vandy. How important is it that some of your team has that going into
it? Yeah, it'll be different. It'll be different. 2 years ago, we barely squeaked by them. We went in there, and Marcus fumbled first play of the game. He doesn't fumble very often, but that's what happened. But our defense played extremely well. I think Shaq Wilson got a pick as they were going in early in the game, running back to midfield. Shoot, they could have easily beat us that day. DJ Swearinger knocked the pass down at the end there. Guy had a step on us. We had some good fortune to beat those guys 17-13. Connor got hurt, came back in the game. It was a tough game, very tough, difficult game. Man, very, very likely could be the same thing.
Coach, this summer you were talking about Sky Moore.